Hey, Tim Berglund with Confluent here to tell you about Kafka Topics. Now, these events that Kafka manages, they have a tendency to proliferate. I mean, just think of what's happened to you today since breakfast. There are a lot of events in the world, and we're going to need a system for organizing them. Now, Kafka's fundamental unit of event organization is called a topic. And if you've never heard of a topic before, for now, you can think of it being something like a table in a relational database, right? It's got a name and it's a container for things that are probably similar to one another. As a developer using Kafka, when you actually start writing code against this thing, the topic is the unit of abstraction that you're probably going to think about the most. There are lots of other little pieces and internals and interesting things to know, but that named topic tends to stand out as the thing that you think about. You create different topics, usually to hold different kinds of events, and you can create different topics to hold filtered and transformed versions of the same kind of event. So remember that smart thermostat example I'm so fond of talking about. You could have one topic that has all of the thermostats in the whole network phoning home, all those go into one topic, and then you could have a filtered one that contains only the messages from thermostats that are in places that are hot right now for some value of hot, for example. So the same kinds of events transformed and filtered from one topic to another. That's completely fine to do in Kafka. You may sometimes hear topics referred to as queues. I hear people say Kafka queue sometime, and I gently but firmly correct them when they do. It's probably not precise to say queue. It's right to say log. A topic is a log of events. And the good news is logs are really easy to understand because they are super simple data structures with well-known semantics. First of all, they're append-only. When you write a new message or new thing, you log a new thing, it always goes on the end, right? Never do you insert a line. If you just think of like application logging, like if you're a Java developer, use log4j or one of the other 600 logging APIs that have wrapped that and other things. You don't put a message in the middle of a log file. That's not a thing. You put it on the end. That's how you use a log. And second, logs can only be read by maybe seeking to an arbitrary offset in the log and then scanning sequential log entries. By default, these are not indexed things. And certainly Kafka topics are not indexed. We can seek to an offset and then scan forward from there. Third, the events in a log are immutable. Once something has happened, it is exceedingly difficult to make it unhappen. In fact, I might even go so far as to say impossible. You speak words in the heat of an argument, maybe, and later on you wish you could unspeak them. You just can't do it. The event has been produced and there's nothing you can do. So events are immutable. Certainly events in Kafka topics are immutable. And the very simple semantics of a log make it pretty easy for Kafka to deliver high levels of sustained throughput in and out of topics. When you look at that kind of single node performance, occasionally you'll come across some crazy metrics, like some hundreds of thousands of messages being produced and consumed on a single server that, you know, was implemented on a Raspberry Pi with a gigabyte of memory. I exaggerate, but you know how those benchmarks normally work. Kafka is capable of clocking some pretty impressive single node performance numbers. And system-wide, single node performance is usually not the point in a distributed system like Kafka. But because logs are simple, Kafka is able to get a lot out of a little performance-wise, and that's always good news. This also makes it easier to reason about the replication of topics, which we'll talk more about later, meaning the fact that events are immutable. That just makes it easier to think about making copies of things and putting them in different places. All kinds of simplifying assumptions happen as a result of immutability. Logs are also fundamentally durable things. Right? A queue you think of as being somehow a little ephemeral. You put things in it and somebody's going to get those things out and then they're going to be gone. And traditional enterprise messaging systems, they have things called topics and queues, which store messages temporarily to buffer them between a source and a destination. But Kafka topics are logs. And I belabor this point really because it matters. There's nothing inherently temporary about the data in a log. Now, a Kafka topic can be configured for the messages in it to expire after they've reached a certain age. They'll like fall off the edge of the world. And you can also configure that by size once the topic has reached a certain size, but age is more typical, retention period is more typical. That can be as short as a few seconds or as long as a few years or even literally infinity. So these really are durable things and that data can live forever. And the logs that underlie those Kafka topics under the covers, they're files stored on disk. So when you write an event to a topic, it's as durable as it would be if you had written it to a file system or any database that you ever trusted. The simplicity of the log as a data structure and the immutability of the contents in it are, in my opinion, keys to Kafka's success as a critical component in modern data infrastructure. They enable us to make a number of simplifying assumptions in other parts of the system that are just delightful and lead to all kinds of really beautiful architectures. But still, logs are just the beginning.